Stanley Park has been the jewel of Vancouver since 1887. The citizens were so protective of it that it took a half century before a road could be built through the park. That road would lead to the Lion's Gate Bridge, that is, once a local businessman convinced the Irish brewing tycoon Sir Arthur Guinness to pay for the bridge. In 1932, the Guinness Syndicate bought 4,000 acres of West Vancouver Mountainside. For them, this bridge would be the way that future homeowners could commute. Construction finally started in 1937. The steel cable suspension bridge is 1,517 meters long, and both towers stand 111 meters high. The Lion's Gate Bridge was opened to traffic on November the 12th, 1938. It cost more than $5.5 million to build, and 5,000 vehicles paid a nickel each to cross it on that first day. In May of 1939, King George VI and Queen Elizabeth presided over the official royal opening. Until 1963, it was a toll bridge, and all users of the crossing, including horses, had to pay. In 1986, the Guinness Brewing Company paid for the lights that dot the span, as a gift to the city for the Expo 86 that was held here. Built by a land speculator and a beer company during the Depression, it was initially a two-lane bridge. It now carries three lanes of traffic and has become the signature piece of the Vancouver skyline.